Yes, the opponent Morgan. It's like I have done that in real life before in friendly matches, but usually you get punished by the universe in some kind of way that's comedic to everyone but you. But I mean, having two extra cards is a real big deal. So my first thought playing mono blue is I don't want to not F6. I love to just skip through turns, but having to, whatever this is, I'm gonna force spike. Yep. Having to leave mana up is just so irritating. Like, oh my god. But we're at a point where we can F6. I'm gonna throw down the Temple Garden. I'm not gonna bluff counters that we don't have. I'm not gonna hope to repeal a one drop. If the opponent plays a crazy three drop, that's gonna suck, but we have options to pull back ahead later. Alright, let's definitely repeal that just to prevent a card draw for a turn. We are flooding a little bit. There's an essence scatter. Hopefully we can treachery that Dark Confidant and ride it to victory. Or yeah, draw the Dalkin Shackles, something. Something just dumb. I hope so. Opponent only has two cards other than the Confidant, but Confidant is likely to re-buy at least one card, if not more, so. Interesting. Life payment for a birthing pod. That's interesting. One card left, but with what the opponent has a pretty nice combination of stuff in play, so it's gonna be a fight for sure. If we get a longer game, we can maybe Vampire Hexmage. We can maybe drain the opponent of resources in their deck. Like if the opponent sacks a bunch of stuff to birthing pod, and then we reset with upheaval. That's a nice combo. Then it's like, what is the opponent, what is all this for? Yeah, the old Blood Gas Birthing Pod combo is a tasty one. For a Vampire Nighthawk. One card left by the opponent. We could treachery the Nighthawk and then swing. But I would maybe rather take the Confidant. At 20 life, it seems like a nice thing to take from the opponent for us. But we'll see what we draw on our turn. Maybe draw Vodalken Shackles and we can take both. Drat. Yeah, well, let's take the Confidant. It just prevent the opponent from drawing cards and drawing cards ourselves is gonna be nice. Untap up to five lands. It's weird that it's not targeted and you can untap the opponents. Okay, passing the turn. We have Essence Scatter up. I'm not gonna attack with the Night Veil because it's just gonna get humped by the Vampire Nighthawk. Hope the opponent doesn't have a way to something they can tutor that kills enchantments. There's a good chance they do, but it would mean maybe getting rid of the Nighthawk. We'll find out soon enough. I imagine the opponent's consulting their deck list right now, thinking, what do I have? What can I do? But our position is not bad by any means. With the opponent at 13 and us at 20 at this stage of the game, where we're only a few. I mean, we can upheaval next turn if we really need to, and we're gonna have access to that reset button for a while. I'm gonna block the blood get. Okay, weird. I'm gonna block the Blood Ghast. If the opponent plays a pump spell, then awesome, they have a pump spell in their deck. But I think they're thinking they're just gonna replay this. Maybe we get punished in some way, I don't know, but feels worth protecting our life total. And if we trade with something, Boon Satyr. Counter target creature spell, and we can't counter it. So that was really bad. May need to upheaval soon. Problem with upheaval is Elves of Deep Shadow coming down. The opponent's gonna have initiative. So maybe that was a really bad block because we could definitely use. Well, we'll see. If the opponent gets rid of Elves of Deep Shadow, that's good for us, actually. Because it means they're not going to have it post upheaval and they're draining their deck of potential uses, useful stuff. Meanwhile, what have we drawn? Seven lands and, oh god, and seven spells. Don't really have ways to get that off the table at this point, to be completely honest. So we might have gotten hosed here. Is that right? Seven lands, six spells. For people wondering, we can't Essence Scatter because Jace Beleriand and Mystic Snake, which we didn't reveal. This is really bad. So I'm gonna play the Jace rather than the Mystic Snake. Target us with a draw. Try to see what we can find to get out of this. There's a Daze. So we have Daze and Essence Scatter, but the problems are on the battlefield. May need to chump block a Dark Blast at some point. Definitely plussing Jace was an option that I considered. I know I didn't explain that. I just didn't really want to give the opponent extra cards at all. There were some pros and cons, and it was close, and I made it a judgment. I believe that plussing it was correct, but I didn't. Essence Scatter that. We do have Daze, so hopefully the opponent slams something epic. And we're just like, nah. Because now the Hexmage can just take that thing down. We'll trade if possible. I'm going to take the hit of 6 so that we can keep the Confidant for another turn. We can chump next turn. I know maybe we flip something and lose tons of life, and that would be bad. But oh well. All right, so there goes the Hexmage, and here comes something else. Even Birthing Pod is, wow. Okay, well I think it's Vidalkin Shackles or bust at this point. Mirari's Wake is more life than I want to pay. My dying play is going to be playing a Volcanic Island to pretend that we're red, and then I'm going to concede so that it's the last thing they remember. So that's what you get for celebrating mulligans. Where did my cards go? Where did everything go? Maybe we have too much mana? I don't know. Take a look here. So, Trigon Predator and Krosan Grip might be nice as ways to kill Birthing Pod. Trigon Predator does not get through a Nighthawk, so it's less reliable. I would be tempted to play with the Krosan Grip and to remove. Maybe remove Kira. I don't really see Untargetable. It kind of stands out, like, as something. We don't necessarily need to protect creatures in play. It didn't come up that game, and it's only a 3 mana 2/2. So that's going to be my cut. Trigon Predator, I'm debating on. Old Man of the Sea could be decent in this matchup. It's a combo with Mirari's Wake. But I think I'm going to not play either of these creatures, and maybe that's wrong. Actually, oh, it's too late now. Woo.